kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. And now it's time for the coin toss, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Collier has the ball teed up, and we're just about ready to get this one started. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 25-yard line. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Middle for a nice run. From their own 29-yard line, second down. Scrambling around. They bring him down. They get to the quarterback and end that play before it even got started.
This young man didn't even have a chance to make something happen. It's tough to find your receivers when the defense is in your face like that.
Goes out of bounds around the 31-yard line. That makes it fourth and four. Morales is the punter. He really got a hold of that one. Tackle at the 24. The Eagles have got a guy at quarterback that is a true leader. We found that out this week talking to him.
We sure did, Brad. It was interesting this week, and as you and I prepared for this game, finding out that he called a players-only meeting without any of the coaches just to get this team focused and let them understand what it takes to go on the road and to win this kind of game. And when you have that kind of leadership, you got a real chance to be able to go on the road and win.
That brings us second and nine. From their own 25-yard line, second down. Quickly, and he's got his man, and they make the stop around the 32-yard line.
That'll bring up third and two.
He's to the 40, and he's tackled around the 41-yard line.
Terrific execution by the entire offense to make that run work and to get the third down conversion.
From their own 41-yard line, first down.
Go for it.
Has some daylight. Tackle at the 49-yard line. And that'll be a gain of 10 by the running back.
That'll make it second and inches.
It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker.
Black five.
Takes the ball right, and he hits him hard at the 50-yard line. Up another first down.
Well, this really works on a defense's psyche. You can see the guys on defense right now just trying to catch their wind. Once again, they had a chance to bring this drive to a halt, but were unable to do it. The offense really seems to be clicking right now.
Adams gains around 5 yards on the draw play from scrimmage.
That'll make it second and four.
And this play is number 8 on the drive.
Here we go, here we go.
to about the 33. So with that run, they pick up another first.
Just a nice job again up front by the offensive line. They're doing a good job of neutralizing the defensive front, and it's allowed them to move the ball down the field.
And they'll run him again. And he's taken down right around the 34. Here's play number 10 on the drive. And he carries the ball for a nice game. A 5-yard pickup by the halfback on the misdirection. They line up for another third down, and they've had no problem converting their first two. He's hit and taken down. Slings it to his fullback.
Excellent job here by the defense to sniff that one out before it turned into a first down.
Trying to take the lead by a field goal. It's up. Looks long enough. And he splits the uprights. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Eagles are right where they want to be early in this one, partner.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. And they get nice yardage on that run. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. On the ground, and he won't get back to the line.
Great effort here by the wideout to secure the ball and pick up some extra yardage.
First and 10. Ball on the 48-yard line. This game's already shaping up to be a good one as we head to the second quarter. 3-0, Eagles. And we welcome you back to the action here, and we have got a tight one going on in quarter number two. He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line. It's second down, 7 to go. Ball on the 49-yard line. The receiver, and down he goes at the 39.
This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
They go to the back, and he's hit immediately in the backfield.
I think anytime you lose yardage, it's frustrating as a ball carrier. It's very frustrating as a play caller. It makes you a little bit more hesitant maybe to go back to a certain play. The biggest thing you want to do as an offensive coordinator is get the offense over the sideline after the series, make sure everybody's on the same page, and then show the confidence that you still have in them despite this play that you're going to go right back to the running back and trust that offensive line.
What a throw for a big game.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
From the 24-yard line, first down. He's going to try and scramble.
decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. And he tucked that one in for about 5 yards. So it's second down now. They need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Fires out to his wideout. And they're in. Touchdown. And he tacks on the extra point. A 9-play, 75-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Momentum swings have been fairly even, and with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Play, and the defense was ready for it. From their own 24-yard line, second down. He's knocked out of bounds at the 30-yard line. The sub package in there defensively in this 5-wide receiver set. Now he tries to buy some time. He's to the 40. And a big run on third down.
Anytime you can move the ball like this, you're putting a lot of pressure on that defense.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 42-yard line. Back with a carry. He's taken down at about the 39-yard line. Here they come. He gets sacked on the play.
That's a loss of 2 yards.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 48. After the sack, it's now fourth and long. And they're coming after this punter. Both defenses really played well so far.
Well, up to this point, both defenses have dominated this football game. We'll see if they can hold on to that mentality the rest of the way.
There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Fires out quick. It's picked off. Here's an opening. Down the sideline. And he scores. Touchdown. So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a 3-point lead with this extra point. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Collier has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
I think this defense has played well enough to be able to win this game, obviously. But at some point, you'd love to see their own offense feed off of some of the confidence that their defense is playing with, because up to this point, the defense is keeping them in the game, but the offense isn't quite doing enough to be able to build on that lead.
Now he's scrambling. They'll bring him down to the 38-yard line. From their own 38-yard line, it's first down. He's scrambling. He's into the open field. He decides to run with it. Tackle made at the 47. From the 47-yard line, first down. He's on the run. Now he's going to run and watch out. Good open field tackle. McKeon picks up about 7 yards on the scramble. The offense calls a timeout, and that was their first timeout. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. And he shoved out of bounds around the 34-yard line. From the 34-yard line, first down. Zips it to the tight end. Brought down around the 21-yard line. The offense calls a timeout. That was their second timeout. Catches it, and he's looking for more. He's tackled at the 13-yard line. He's got it with room to run. And he's in there. Touchdown.
I like how the quarterback, the offensive line, and the receivers made a concerted effort to get into the end zone.
The extra point. A 7-play, 76-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
Morales has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Eagles have really got some work to do, I think, Kirk, in the second half, because from what we've seen from their quarterback so far, if he's their star, it's not shining right now, and they got to find somebody else to light up the sky a little bit.
Well, I think collectively as a head coach, an offensive coordinator, quarterback coach, they're all going to have to get together and take some time to visit with this quarterback at halftime and try to find out if they can somehow get him going. And the other thing, think about is maybe this is where the running backs, maybe it's this is their week to take some of the pressure off of. Maybe the receivers, the offensive line, when your star isn't playing up to his abilities, he has a tendency to press. Somebody else has to step up their game and take some of the pressure off of.
They give to the tailback. He's to the 40. Knocked out of bounds around the 43-yard line. First down. First and 10. Ball on the 43. Got hit and still completed it. And they make the stop at the 48. The Eagles will use their first time out of the half. Call a timeout. That's their second of the half. It's first and 10. Ball on the 23. scrambling around. The Eagles using their third and final timeout.
Great job here converting and keeping this defense on the field. They're getting very tired.
He gets it up, and he's got it. A great first half comes to a close. The score here at Robertson Stadium, the Oilers 14, the Eagles 13.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. What a terrific first half. This is everything we anticipated this game being. And we're going to be riveted to this game, I feel like, David, in the second half, anticipating a terrific finish.
It's fun. It's living up to the hype every single time. We can't even turn the channel here. We got it on the big screen, on the big 60-inch. Yes, it's quite nice, by the way, too. The weather's nice and warm. It's beautiful. Got some chips. We're opening them up a little bit. But great game, living up to the hype. It definitely feels like both teams are evenly matched. It feels like it can go either way. It feels like it's going to come down to the wire. And the only thing I hope it doesn't come down to is a kicker. Please don't come down to a kick in the end. Both these teams playing great D, playing great O, you know, physical, you know, pounding on each other, making big plays. Don't come down to a finesse kick by like a soccer player, please.
Just about time to get you back out for the second half. Brad and Kirk will be along in just a second. You're looking forward to keeping an eye on everything around the country here. Got a good, like a game score.
We're locked and loaded. We got all the big screens going. You're going to be looking to hand out some helmet stickers later. We're loaded, man.
I'll try. You think you can keep on your shoes in the second half?
I'll try to. They stinky?
Yes. Brad and Kirk, you're at a safe distance. Take it away.
Welcome back to the action. Second half just about set to begin. We got a tight game here. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Brad, this has been a great game to watch. A lot of competitive spirit out there. The offenses seem to be going up and down the field. Back and forth we go. I think the winner will be which defense can make that pivotal stop to secure a victory.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Cruz off the left side. He gains a couple of yards on the carry.
Boy, this senior safety provides such solid run support. He stopped him in his tracks that time.
It's second down and 8. Ball on their own 27. He scrambled, and he's going to be sacked for a loss. From their own 23-yard line, third down. He fires. Oh, he had the pick and he dropped it. And that one probably should have been picked off.
Yeah, are you kidding me? There's a blanket around that receiver. Somebody else had to be open.
Thornburg is waiting for the snap. Oh, excellent punt. McGrew fields it at the 30. He makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line. The offense is coming out on the field, and they haven't had any problem finding the end zone lately. Tackle around the 39-yard line. Picked up a yard of anything on that run.
This guy is very physical, and he does a good job of taking on blockers.
From their own 39-yard line, second down. Here comes the pressure. And he's tackled around the 47-yard line. Gains his way to the 39-yard line. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Play fake. He goes downtown. That close to being intercepted.
Hey, this guy's got to forget about the drop. Remember, he was in good position to make a play.
And down he goes, around the 31-yard line. From the 31-yard line, it's first down. Taken down around the 28-yard line.
That'll make it second and seven.
Double tight, guys, double tight. Four down, four down.
He makes it to the 25-yard line.
That'll bring up third and four.
This is the eighth play of this drive. Tackle at the 24-yard line.
Well, that's a big-time stop by the defense. You know, Brad, one of the things that all defensive coordinators always try to emphasize is their ability to stop offenses on third down. That is a big stop, and I think it's going to have a lot to do with the outcome of this football game.
It's so tough to move the ball forward. Even a 5-yard setback can do damage to a drive.
So it's fourth down. They're going to try a long field goal here. It's up, looks long enough, and he nails the long field goal. Morales, ready to kick. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Everywhere we go in college football, everybody's got a T-shirt that says finish, finish. Whether that means finish the game or finish the drive. Right now, this offense is moving the ball, but they're not finishing the drive. They got to execute better down closer to the opponent's territory.
Nice run, and he's brought down. The halfback option, good for 7 yards.
That'll bring up second and three.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Run there.
Man, it's always a plus if you're able to pick up the first down with the running game.
He fights forward to about the 40. From their own 40-yard line. It's second down.
Black five, 3-9.
He's taken down at about the 43-yard line. To about the 44-yard line. It looks like they're going to go after this punt. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. So you wonder what kind of excitement we'll see this time around. Slings it. They'll bring him down at the 32-yard line. From their own 32-yard line. First down. Dennis gets the carry. And they hit him in the backfield. Game on our hands. The score here at Robertson Stadium, the Oilers 17, the Eagles 13. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter. Out to his wideout. Tackle made around the 38-yard line. From their own 38-yard line. Third down. He steps out at the 38.
No gain. That makes it fourth and four.
The defense has everybody on the line. I think they're going to come after this one. It's away, and it's a booming punt. Tackle made at the 31. This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. On the ground, and he won't get back to the line. From their own 29-yard line, second down. Get to that quickly. Brought down at the 38-yard line. It to the 47.
To be successful, you've got to be able to come through on third down, and that's just what they did with that big run.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 47. Tackled after a decent pickup.
That's good for being on 3 yards. That makes it 7-6.
Tackled at the 45-yard line. They'll line it up again on third down.
That'll bring up third and two.
Just under three to go in regulation. And he carries the ball for a nice game. Him hard at the 12. Big gain there for the first down.
There was some miscommunication down there by the defense that allowed for that big gain.
Here's the eighth play of the series. The run, and he's taken down behind the line.
That brings up second and 18.
From the 15-yard line, second down. He gets out to about the 12-yard line.
And
this This is the 10th play of the drive. Quick throw, incomplete, one of his receivers. It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. He's scrambling. Sheds that one. Touchdown! And now they're winning this ball game. The Eagles knew they had a star quarterback. He came through for them in the clutch.
And this defense knows how good this quarterback is. In fact, that's why they decided to try to get as much pressure on him as they could. They weren't able to get home, leaving him plenty of time to make the throw, and he delivered when he needed to.
And he converts the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. Just under two to go in the game. And they make the stop at the 34. Looks middle, got his back. Good open field tackle. He's going to try and scramble. He's at midfield. There's a fumble. It's the running back who picks it up, and he dives forward. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 41-yard line. And it's caught. And he is drilled at the 36.
This is smart, efficient play calling. You don't need to make the highlight reel on each play.
Makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line.
They don't have enough time to play dink and dunk football like this. They need to move the ball and do it quickly.
Caught with room to work. He gets hit out of bounds around the 23-yard line. It's first and 10. Ball on the 23. Shot to the open receiver, and he can't hang on to the ball. And this is the eighth play of the drive.
That makes it second and 10.
Under a minute left. Quick strike to the receiver, and he's immediately tackled. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 12.
Oh, yeah, I'm coming. Oh, yeah, I'm coming.
Strike to his receiver. No good.
Accuracy is such a vital part of being a quarterback. You've got to have an ability to lay the ball right into your guy's hands.
And this is the 11th play of the current drive. Zips it out to his runner, and he's got him again. And that sets them up with a first and goal. Now he tries to buy some time. Tries to get around the corner. The play clock's at double zero. They just took too long.
Delay of game. Offense.
He makes the PAT. They're lined up to kick, and they might just kick it short to prevent a long return. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Eagles have got to be just a little bit careful that they lean too much on a star player here in this stage of the game.
Yeah, but having a quarterback that understands what this defense wants to try to do to slow this offense down is very, very important. Now he's just got to stay calm, make good decisions, and move his offense down the field.
Quick pass. And they make the stop at the 23-yard line. Loss of about two.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
From their own 23-yard line. Second down. Fires out to his receiver. And down he goes around the 40-yard line.
Not a real fancy play here, just a smartly run route. Good protection and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
He's on the run. He's at midfield. Decides to slide. The Eagles using their third and final timeout. So this is it right here. One last play and one last chance to win the game. If they can get the Hail Mary, they'll pull out the miracle win. He airs it out. Almost picked off. A great game here today in a tight one. 24-20. That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.